thought if I sat like this with my hands folded on my desk, I would be invisible and nobody would attack me and I could get through the day unscathed. And then teachers, and the teachers from my grammar school days that I wish I had written to, I wish I had written thank you notes to them for reading poetry out loud, for reading stories out loud, for making me fall in love with the way English sounded. I loved Italian. Italian was my house. Italian was the sound of music that was in my house. But then English was the music of America for me. And I fell in love with the poets that they read to us. They're very out-of-date poets at this point. They're certainly very out of fashion at this point, but I loved them. I loved hearing them. I loved hearing the way English sounded when it was read by, my parents spoke a very broken version of English, extremely broken. And so to hear a teacher, and I thought they were upper class, I mean, what did I know? They never left the street, so I didn't know. But it seemed to me that there were upper class people reading these poems and these stories, and they made me hear a kind of music in the language that I feel I absorbed into my own skin, and then I decided I wanted to write myself. And I started writing at a very early age. I've continued to write, I'm actually not at a very early age anymore. And somebody said, do you ever run out of ideas? No, never run. It's like being a peasant. You know, you have to keep going no matter what. And so I feel the same way about writing. For me, Patterson has been a big influence and a place I love, a place I see that is looked down upon by a lot of people because there are in certainly neighborhoods of poverty and neighborhoods of despair. But there's so much beauty there if you look around. To me, I want to celebrate the different ethnicities and races that come into the city, the way they give it a kind of energy and enthusiasm and keep the city alive. I see there's an Arab school around the corner from the Hamilton Club where my office now is, and that was a gentleman's club. I couldn't have gotten in, as many people in this room could not have gotten in, but then maybe some of you could have, but a good number of you could not have gotten into that club. So around the corner there's this Arab school and Arab language school, basically. And I see the mothers bringing their kids and walking up the street with the kids. And it reminds me so much of my own family. I look at them and I think, you know, this whole movement of immigrants into the country, the very variety of people in this country is perfect fodder for poetry. It's what we celebrate as Americans, and is what I celebrate in my poetry, in the anthologies I've done, in my magazine, because it seems to me that that's a very important function. I think the other thing that for me has kept me writing is that for a long time I thought, because I was poor as a kid, that I had to write and throw in a lot of Greek gods and crap into school. And that's where my lower class comes in. And I thought I had to prove I was smart. You know, I had to have references to Greek gods and esoteric language and all that. And then I went back to graduate school when my children were in high school. And a graduate school professor, who was a very upper middle class man, said to me, you know, it's in this poem about your father that you find the story you have to tell. And that man gave me courage. I thought, well, maybe I can write about being an immigrant, about not speaking English when I went to school, about being a wife, a daughter, a grandmother, a mother, about 19th Street and 17th Street in the Riverside section of Patterson. Maybe I can write about the factories, about working in a factory myself when I was in college, about all the negative comments I made, complaining and moaning about working in this factory when my parents worked in factories for 50 years without ever complaining, without ever saying, I can't do this anymore. And so, I don't know, I guess I lost the thread there. but for me, my practice is that I write all the time. A teacher, I had Allen Ginsberg's teacher as my high school teacher. I was very lucky. And I had Mr. Irvin, who liked the way I read poetry. And I was in alpha classes, really upper middle class kids. And there I am, this little immigrant kid. I look like a woman could do. And she kept calling on me to read the poems because I love them. I love the language. I love the way it sounded. And she loved it. And she knew I loved it. So instead of calling on these other kids, every day she'd call on me. And I'd read Yeats and William Carlos Williams and Amy Lowell. And I loved the sound of it. It was almost like a peach or a pear in my mouth. I could taste the language. And I'm so grateful to her for doing that. I'm also grateful to Mr. Weiss, who was my English teacher when I was 14. And he came to every meeting I ever did in New York City, even during a hurricane. He'd come with a little backpack. He was very thin. He retired maybe 10 years ago from Eastside High School. But he would show up. He had an apartment in New York, and he would show up at every meeting, even in Queens or the Bronx or wherever I was. Here he'd be, even slogging through a hurricane to get to a meeting. It felt so good and so validating to have him there and to have that support. I'm probably talking way too much. I just want to say one more thing, and that I always think of William Carlos Williams saying, universal isn't the particular. And I think so often as a woman poet and as a lower class woman poet and a working class woman poet, you constantly have to fight against people who say, well, why are you writing about your life? Why don't you write about some very esoteric thing? Well, I did that already. I did that for years to try to hide. And I just decided that I was never going to do that again. And that I was going to teach my students to claim the stories they have, to claim their own tears, to claim their own sorrow and loss and joy, and not feel like they have to write. And somebody actually said this to me, why don't you write like a man? That's why I don't write. And I've had wonderful male students who write from their guts, and that's what I really am working really hard to do. And not only in my own work, but I've tried, when I started the Poetry Center in Patterson, people said, you can't start a Poetry Center in Patterson. Nobody's going to come there. That was 38 years ago. I've had every major poet. American poet and some poets from other countries. I've had every major American poet read for me. And it's so wonderful. I wrote their pictures about the office. It's so amazing. And they all came and they gave workshops to people who are from Patterson. But also, we have an audience of people who come from New Jersey, New York, Pennsylvania. And it's been amazing. So don't ever tell me I can't do something. Because nobody's coming, because they've been coming for 38 years now. And I hope if I can keep going, they'll be coming for a long time yet to hear the poets and to take workshops and to love poetry as much as I do. Okay, I'm shutting up now.